Hello friends, today we'll discuss about the classical free electron theory of metal and its derivation or derivation of the electrical conductivity of the conductor. Okay, so we know that metal contains large number of free electrons and hence they are free to move about the whole volume of the element. Okay, these electrons are very good conductor. So according to this, free electron theory of metal consists of iron core having the nucleus and electrons other than the valence electron. Okay, these valence electrons form an electron gas and free to move anywhere within the metal. Okay, so in the theory, force between the conductive electrons the force between the conductive electrons and iron cores are neglected. Both the forces can be neglected so that the total energy of the electron is all kinetic. That is, the potential energy is taken to be zero. Hence, the motion of the electron within the metal is free because there are no collision, similar to the molecule of an ideal gas. So, in order to explain their properties like electrical conductivity, thermal conductivity, Drude and Lorentz, these are the names of the scientists, Drude and Lorentz proposed a classical model which is known as a classical free electron theory of metal and which is based on this following assumptions. So, first assumption is free electrons in a metal resembles molecules of a gas, therefore laws of kinetic theory of gases are applicable to free electron also. Thus, free electrons can be assigned with average velocity, mean free path lambda and mean collision time tau. Okay. Now, second assumption is that the motion of the electrons is completely random, therefore the net electric current is zero. And third assumption is the average kinetic energy of the electron is given by average kinetic energy. We can write the equation 3 by 2 kT is equal to 1 half mc square, or we can write this equation like this: C is equal to root of 3 kT divided by m, where this C indicates average velocity. Okay, this K indicates the Boltzmann constant, T indicates the absolute temperature and M indicates the mass of the electron. Now, next assumption is electric current in the conductor. Now, current produced in the conductor is due to the drift velocity acquired by the electron in the presence of the applied electric field. Next one is the force of attraction and repulsion between the electrons and lattice ion is neglected. There is a force between the or force of attraction and repulsion is there between electron and lattice ions, and that can be neglected. Okay, now next point is expression for electrical conductivity. Okay, now we have to derive the expression for the electrical conductivity, that is denoted by a letter sigma, for the conductor, or we can say for the metal. So for this, consider a conductor having length is small l, area of cross section capital A, having n number, small n is there, n number of free electrons per unit volume. Okay, let V is the potential difference applied between the two ends of the conductor, and E indicates electric field established inside the conductor. Then, according to the Ohm's law is J is equal to sigma into E, give equation number 1, where this sigma indicates the electrical conductivity, J indicates the current density, and which is given by J is equal to I divided by A, give equation number 2. Okay, now again from the equation first. Now, from this equation, we can write equation 3, that is sigma is equal to J divided by E, give equation number 3. Now, after that, consider I be the, capital I is the current flowing through the conductor, and which is given by I is equal to capital N into small e, give equation number 4, where this capital N indicates number of electrons inside the conductor. That capital N, what it indicates? It indicates the number of electrons which is present in a conductor. Okay. Now, if we see this figure, then it is observed that this E indicates the electric field. Okay. Then this V is the potential difference applied between these two ends of the conductor. Okay. A indicates the area of cross section, and this Vd is nothing but the drift velocity of the electron. Okay. Now we know that this Vd is the drift velocity of the electrons. Now electrons travel a distance equal to Vd in 1 second. Therefore, we can write the equation capital N is equal to N into A into Vd. Give equation number 5. Now equation 4 becomes, what is the equation 4? 4 is I is equal to capital, 4 is the I is equal to N into E is there. Okay. So here in equation 4, we just put the value of N. So we get the equation I is equal to N into AVD into E. Okay. But again, we know that J is equal to current density. J is equal to what we get? I is equal to I divided by E is there from equation 2. Therefore, J is equal to, here in this equation, we just put the value of I. That is J is equal to N into A into Vd into E divided by this capital A as it is. Okay. Therefore, AA get cancelled, remaining term, or we can write the equation J is equal to N into E into Vd. Okay. And sigma is equal to J divided by E is there. Here, in this equation, we put the value of J, and which is nothing but N into E into Vd. So, equation of the electrical conductivity sigma is equal to N E Vd divided by capital E. Give equation number 6. Now, if we consider tau is the average time taken by the electron between the two successive collision, then force acting on the electron in presence of the electric field is given by F is equal to E into capital E, which is equal to M into A. This equation can be written according to the Newton's law of motion. Okay, so now from this equation, we can write the equation for the acceleration, that is A is equal to E into capital E divided by M. Now, therefore, Vd is equal to E into E divided by M into tau. Now, here, instead of this A, acceleration is nothing but the velocity per unit time. So, instead of this A, we put V divided by tau. Okay, therefore, equation 6 becomes, 6 is there. Equation 6 is sigma is equal to, okay, here we put in equation 6 value of Vd. Look at here, sigma is equal to, in equation 6 there is the Vd present is there. Okay, so here in equation 6 we put just the value of Vd, E into E divided by M into tau. Therefore, finally we get the equation sigma is equal to N E square, E get cancelled, divided by M into tau. But again, tau is equal to lambda divided by C. Tau is equal to lambda divided by C. Therefore, sigma is equal to N E square lambda divided by M into C. So, from free electron theory, C bar is equal to root of 3 kT divided by M. Therefore, here we put the value of C in above equation. Equation becomes sigma is equal to N E square lambda divided by M into root of 3 kT divided by M. So, finally equation we get sigma is equal to N E square divided by root of 3 M kT, and give equation number 7. Now equation 6 gives the expression for electric conductivity of a conductor. So equation 6, where it is? Equation 6 is it. Now this equation 6, that is sigma is equal to Ne Vd divided by E, that is nothing but the equation of the electrical conductivity of a conductor. Now, next point we'll discuss about resistivity and its temperature dependence. So, resistivity of a material is an intrinsic property of the material, and it is nothing but to resist the flow of electric current. So, another definition of the resistivity is, it is the reciprocal of the conductivity. Simply, we can say that it is the reciprocal of the conductivity. So, it is found that resistivity of a material depends on the temperature. Temperature vary, the resistivity of the material is also vary. So, we can say that resistivity of the material depends on the temperature. Okay. The resistivity of the metallic conductor within a limited range to the temperature is given by a formula. Rho T divided by rho 0 in bracket 1 plus alpha into T minus T 0, where this rho T indicates resistivity at a temperature T. Rho 0 indicates resistivity at a temperature T 0. Alpha indicates the temperature coefficient of the resistivity. Thus, the resistivity of the metallic conductor increases with increasing temperature. Hence, we can say that resistivity of the metallic conductor increases as the temperature is increasing. In terms of the charge density N, the resistivity is given by. Now we can write the equation of the resistivity in terms of the charge density, which is denoted by letter N. So we can write the equation rho is equal to M divided by N e square tau, where this N indicates charge density, tau indicates average time between the collision. So in case of semiconductor, what happens in case of semiconductor? So in semiconductor, N increases with the increasing temperature. Means in semiconductor,